Afternoon to one and all gathered here. So I am Harish. I also work with Sumana and Saroja with CAG. So as you know, this is an interesting webinar that we are organizing. This is something unique, a topic regarding insurance and road safety. So before we begin the webinar, just want to give an overview of how India, as you know, fares with road safety. For example, India accounts for over 10% of the road crash fatalities in the world, and Tamil Nadu is also one of the leading states in India who have a high number of road crashes and road fatalities. And the risk, therefore, for a road crash injury or fatality is really a serious issue in India. So, in addition to driving safely and following the road rules, we can choose to take an appropriate insurance coverage. And legally, under this Motor Vehicle Act, certain kinds of insurance are required. But people are not much aware about the nitty-gritties of insurance. And in addition, it is very important to understand the options available under insurance. There are various categories of insurance available which the public are not aware of. This webinar is a step towards that direction to help people choose a good insurance for them and help take a informed decision. And insurance can also be useful to cover hospitalization, damage to vehicles, or in case of death, we can provide support to the family members of the victim. So, without much delay, I would like to carry forward this webinar by inviting Mr. Satyajit of Future Risk. He would be explaining in simple terms how insurance can be useful to a citizen. What is insurance? All the basic to help us understand the fundamentals of insurance. Over to you, Mr. Satyajit, sir.
Do you want to just quickly introduce Mr. Satyajit?
Yeah. Sorry. Sorry, there is some network.
Okay, why don't I do that while you figure out your network problem? So as Harish mentioned, Satyajit is with Future Risk, which is an insurance brokerage. But he is also an insurance and risk management consultant with over a decade of experience. And he is a fellow of the Insurance Institute of India and an associate of the Chartered Insurance Institute UK. So clearly he has a lot of knowledge and experience, and he's here to share some of that information and knowledge with us, which I'm sure will be very, very useful. So over to you, Mr. Satyajit, to take it forward.
Thank you so much, Sumana. Thank you so much for having me over to give a briefing on this. So very good afternoon to one and all. I'm Satyajit. As highlighted, I represent an insurance broking company called Future Risk Insurance Brokers. Typically, we arrange insurance covers for individuals or companies, be it their personal insurance or their company's employees or for their assets, whatever it is. So we deal with a variety of insurance policy, mostly in terms of recommending what coverage should be sought and what kind of coverage would suit what kind of an individual. So that is the basic kind of work that we do. So when it comes to insurance per se for a citizen, I believe it's one of the most important but often overlooked aspects when it comes to financial planning per se. So there's a lot of emphasis on savings. And there's a lot of emphasis on expense as well, but insurance is very rarely seen as a something that is does not really it's not seen as something as being very important to somebody when it comes to planning their finances. But I believe it is one of the most most important tool which helps you hedge against risk over the long period of time. Typically, what insurance does is it helps you minimize your risk in terms of, in case of an unfortunate incident or an unfortunate event wherein you would have to spend a significant amount to recoup or recuperate or to bring yourself back to the original position. As against that, you just pay a small premium over a period of time, which will help you to hedge this risk. So when it comes to insurance, when we talk about for an individual, the most important categories would be for their health, for their life, and for an accident, and as well as for their motor vehicles. So these would be the key insurance that they would need. So as you are aware, motor vehicle, it is compulsory to have an insurance, at least for the third party liability part. The vehicle per se is automatically insured as an optional add-on coverage. I mean, that is primarily what is important to be covered is your motor vehicles, the components as well as the exteriors and all that is definitely needs to be covered. For an individual, your health insurance, accident and life are the three key policies that any member must look at. So to start with, in terms of a health insurance, what it does cover is it helps you hedge against a risk in case of an unfortunate illness, ailment, or an accident, or any of those kind of events. So what a health insurance policy does is, in case a member falls ill due to any kind of a sickness that is defined in the policy, or if there is an accidental hospitalization to a member, or that is any other surgery that is being performed for the insured member, the policy would pay the cost to the extent of which the coverage is present in the policy. So typically what a health insurance policy would cover is all your traditional sickness that is being defined. Like say, for example, if somebody is suffering from a complication arising out of diabetes and there is a surgery that needs to be performed, that would be covered under the scope of insurance. Or say something like a heart transplant or a kidney transplant or something of that sort would also be covered under the scope of insurance. The most convenient part about insurance, health insurance at least, is that most insurance companies would provide a cashless coverage for you, in which case, which means that you wouldn't have to be spending money from your pocket with your money being locked down for a period of about say 30, 40 days until which time it takes for you to get the money back from the insurance company. Instead, in terms of a health insurance policy, what happens is the hospitals and the insurance companies have a direct tie-up where you can, in case of an admission at the hospital, the insurance companies directly settle the claim amount to the hospitals, and only the amount that you are expected to bear or which is not covered as a part of the insurance policy would have to be paid from your pocket. So that is a significant aspect of health insurance is the cashless hospitalization part, which means that it would not impact your immediate cash flow. You don't have to park out a significant portion of your savings till the time that you recover your claim from the insurance company. So apart from ailments, the health insurance policies also covers hospitalization due to any accidents. So if there is any form of an accident, say even if a road accident or if an accidental slippage when playing a sport, there is a damage, say a fracture to the leg, or if there is a surgery that needs to be performed to correct some sort of outcome of the accident, that would also be covered under the scope of insurance. So health insurance is probably one of the most important aspects that every single individual must look at, because India is not a country that is actually subsidized for health per se. At least in the private sector, you do have very inflated costs when it comes to hospital treatment costs as well as remunerant costs. So when you keep that in mind, and when you keep in mind the very limited scope of social security that we have, health insurance is extremely critical. It is very important that one covers themselves as well as their family members under a health insurance, and it is ideal that somebody gets themselves covered as early as possible, preferably in their late 20s or early 30s, because what happens is as you age, the insurance companies would place a restriction under the policy which could limit coverage for pre-existing diseases. For example, if somebody is already having an existing ailment or existing condition, like say for example blood pressure, high blood pressure, and if you buy the policy post after your diagnosis, insurance companies will simply say that they will not pay any claims arising out of blood pressure or its complications. So the earlier it is being procured, the better it is, because the premiums are extremely small when you are at a younger age, because the risk is also very limited for the insurance company. And at a lower age, it is extremely unlikely that most members would suffer from comorbidities or any pre-existing diseases. And they would, in case they are diagnosed with something at a later stage, it would stand covered. So that is extremely important. The other aspect about insurance is is something called an accident coverage or a personal accident policy. This is something that is usually given, as an add-on coverage under your motor policy as well. So your motor insurance will also have a small component called a personal accident, which means that in case of an unfortunate accidental death or a dismemberment to to the insured member, the insurance company will pay the said sum insured, or would pay the said benefit amount. So for example, if somebody is and this coverage can also be bought separately, it need not be a part of the motor vehicle policy, can be bought separately as well. So what this does is, typically in case a member has an unfortunate accident, their kin will be compensated in case of an unfortunate death, or if it is a disablement or a temporary or a partial or a total disablement, depending on the degree of disablement, the insurance companies would pay a certain percentage. Like say for example, if there is a loss of one limb or two limbs, insurance company will pay the entire sum insured or whatever amount that you're covered for. If it is a loss of one limb, it would be, say for example, 50% or 75% of the amount. So the amount of claim that is paid is again depending on the degree of disability. In case of an unfortunate accidental death, 100% of whatever is being covered would be paid to your next of kin or your legal heir. If it is declared. And apart from this, the accident policy also covers accidental medical expenses to a certain extent. So this would be for accidental medical expenses that are otherwise not covered under hospitalization. If there are, say, for example, minor expenditure, like for example, if somebody has to just go and get a dressing done for their fracture with a doctor after an accident, those kind of minor expenditures are also covered under the scope of an accident policy under an extension. So this is how a personal accident insurance policy works. And finally, we have our life insurance policy, which is again a very, very critical component which should be included or considered when there is a financial angle involved. So when it comes to life insurance, there are typically two different kinds of policies that the insurance companies issue. One is covering only death, which means that you pay a premium and the insurance company pays whatever coverage amount or sum insured in the policy in case of an unfortunate death of the member for the tenure of the policy. Say for example, you take a policy for 20 years, you pay a premium every year. And in that 20-year period, if there is an unfortunate demise, the insurance companies would pay whatever is the compensation to your kin. The second type of policy is called an endowment or a return of premium. So there are multiple kinds of phrases that the insurance companies use. So in this case, this is there, apart from the death coverage, there would also be a return on the premium that you had paid. So say, for example, you pay a premium for a period of 10 years or 15 years to the insurance company. At the end of the 15th year, the insurance company would pay you back all the premiums paid along with interest, along with bonuses that they have earned from the performance that they have had. So under most policies, these are guaranteed benefits. Under a lot of policies, these are also non-guaranteed benefits, again depending on how the insurance company performs over the period, over a period of time. So under the second category of policies, you have both a coverage for death as well as a return at the end of the period. So this would also, you know, it would give the kind of flexibility where it would act as a risk mitigation tool. At the same time, it would also act as a savings tool as well for most members, because at the end of the day, there is also a return coming in terms of a return of premium or bonuses or whatever it may be paid, depending on the insurance company. And so apart from this, we also have a motor vehicle insurance coverage, which again is been mandated by the government to be made mandatory. So the third party liability insurance for any vehicle that is being driven on public roads is mandatory according to the Indian insurance laws. And that is the own damage portion, that is your vehicles, your chassis, your exteriors, and your engine parts, and all the other components can also be covered under the scope of insurance. So this would typically be given as a package policy, and there will also be a small component for an accident built into the motor vehicle policy as well. This would cover the driver as well as the pinion. In case of a car, it would also cover any of the other passengers that may travel in the car. There will be a small component that is built in under the scope of insurance as well. So this is a very brief summary of what kinds of insurances are available out there for individuals per se. And as I had previously mentioned, insurance is very critical when you plan out when you are making a financial plan for yourself, because we always look at the savings aspect, and we always look at what we can really get up or save, or how much can we actually put in our bank. That's something very tangible that you can see in your bank account, that you have saved so much of money. But insurance looks more like an expense, because it's something that we keep paying to somebody else. It's not something that we realize that we are actually paying to get ourselves covered. But then again, the kind of expenses or the kind of associated charges that do come out in terms of most of these, say for example your health insurance, or in case of an ailment, a simple hospital visit would cost somewhere in the range of about 40,000-50,000 rupees for a very minor ailment. If there is something major, we're talking about a huge chunk of your savings being drained out. So that is why insurance is extremely critical. And the other forms of insurance, like say accident and your term life insurance, is also very key, because this gives a lot of protection, financial protection, to your next of kin, to your family members in case of an unfortunate demise, because again, this would hedge the risk of loss of employment or anything of that sort. So you loss of income that does take place in case, you know, you're a breadwinning member of the family. So this is a very basic brief about what kinds of insurances are available in the market. So I'd be happy to take any questions if we do have.
Thank you very much, Mr. Satyajit sir. It was an enlightening lecture. Though it was a brief, we could understand what is meant by life insurance, what is meant by accidental insurance, and the importance of not looking at insurance as something of an expense, but as an investment which would help us during tough times that would occur for anyone at any time. So, sir, we'll have the questions session after the next speaker also speaks, and then we'll take questions.
Great, sure. That works. Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. Now, I would like to invite Mr. Vijay Raghavan, sir. He's an experienced advocate who has over 30 years of experience in bar, and he has written several books on law. For example, he has co-authored a book, MV Laws, Motor Vehicle Laws, with Justice Kannan, in Justice K. Kannan in 2008. And he has published Constitution and Its Making, Musings, Anecdotes, and Episodes on 26th November on the Constitution Day. And next month, he's going to publish another book called Sam Manekshaw's Beloved Armed Forces by Kalai Magal Publications. As being a distinguished author, and he's also a resource person at Tamil Nadu Judicial Academy and National Judicial Academy. Now I request Mr. Vijay Raghavan, sir, to give his valuable thoughts on insurance and road crashes, a legal perspective on all the insurance related issues with regard to road crashes. Over to you, sir, Vijay Raghavan, sir.
Yeah, good afternoon. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yeah, I was told I can go bilingual. Everybody is comfortable, Tamil
yes,
and
English. Yeah, yes.
But
yes.
That makes it a natural thing, you know. First thing, good afternoon to everybody, and stay safe and take care. And particularly during these COVID times, insurance has become very, very important perspective to be kept in mind. Whenever you talk of insurance, two principles always should come to the fore. Number one, like Mr. Satyajit was saying, investment insurance is an expense, is perceived more as an expense than as an investment. It is an investment and not an expense. So that you should keep in mind. And second thing is, when you make an expense for, when you provide for insurance, please understand it's not a fixed deposit which you will get in return with interest. Insurance is basically risk-based. So let me give you some examples. Now, for instance, what Lord Denning said way long back is, an insurance policy should be very carefully read. What the big clause gives, the small clause takes it away. That you should understand very clearly. Or like what Groucho Marx in US talked about insurance. He said insurance policy covers a fall from a height, but the actual fall on the ground will be excluded from the coverage. So you should be very careful about, while reading an insurance policy, you should be very careful about that. Now the topic that is suggested or taken up for the webinar is risks and road crashes. So now, the motor vehicle policy, I will talk about. I will not go into the health cover or accident insurance of different kinds and all that. I will confine myself to the motor vehicle policy as such. Now, first and foremost thing, insurance and road safety do not go together at all. They are actually opposites of each other. Insurance edutha road la risk kadaiyadunnathu kadaiyadu. Road la safety illada பாதிக்கப்படுறவாளுக்கு என்ன மாதிரி இன்சூரன்ஸ் எடுக்கணும்ன்றது கிரைடீரியா. இன்சூரன்ஸ் ஹஸ் நத்திங் டு டூ வித் ப்ரிவென்ஷன் ஆஃப் ரோட் ஆக்சிடென்ட்ஸ். நத்திங், நோ இன்சூரன்ஸ் பாலிசி எவர் ப்ரிவென்ட்ஸ் அன் ஆக்சிடென்ட் ஃப்ரம் டேக்கிங் பிளேஸ். ஸோ டோன்ட் ஹேவ் தட் பெர்செப்ஷன் அட் ஆல். அவர் ஈவன் வென் யூ ஸ்டார்டட் யூ டாக் அபவுட் த ஸ்டாட்டிஸ்டிக்ஸ் பார்ட் ஆஃப் இட். ஐ வில் நாட் போர் யூ வித் தட். ஜஸ்ட் ஐ வில் ஜஸ்ட் ஸ்கேர் யூ வித் ஜஸ்ட் ஒன் தாட். எவ்ரி 6 minutes there is a death on India from a road accident. Every 6 minutes. And the total amount that is calculated all over the world from road accident loss is $550 billion. $550 billion. It's almost 2.5%. India, it's about 2.5% of the GDP itself every year in terms of deaths and maims and injuries and so on and so forth. So, on the perspective, with that in mind, please understand this. India, registered motor vehicles are possibly the highest in number on a daily basis. For instance, Tamil Nadu, undi, every day, there are about 2.5 lakh to 3 lakh vehicles which are being registered. Every day. Tractors, number of tractors, India, in the farm loan,
நடக்கிற ப்ரொட்டஸ்டை தேடி பார்த்தாலும் ஃபுல்லா டிராக்டர் தான் நின்றுட்டு இருக்கு. ரிபப்ளிக் டே அன்னைக்கும் டிராக்டர்ல ஊர்வலம் போறேன்னு பயமுறுத்திட்டு இருக்காங்க. ஸோ நம்பர் ஆஃப் டிராக்டர்ஸ் இந்தியால இஸ் த ஹையஸ்ட் இன் நம்பர். பிளீஸ் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் தட் பர்ஸ்பெக்டிவ் இன் மைண்ட். இப்போ அப்படி பாக்குறச்சு இன்சூரன்ஸ், மோட்டார் இன்சூரன்ஸ் இஸ் கம்பல்சரி இன் இந்தியா அண்டர் மோட்டார் வெஹிக்கிள்ஸ் ஆக்ட் 1988 செக்ஷன் 146. யூ மே நாட் பி வரிட் அபவுட், யூ மே நாட் பாதர் அபவுட் தி ப்ரொவிஷன்ஸ், பட் ஜஸ்ட் செக்ஷன் 146 டாக்ஸ் அபவுட் கம்பல்சரி மோட்டார் இன்சூரன்ஸ். அந்த கம்பல்சரி மோட்டார் இன்சூரன்ஸ் சொல்லச்சே வாட் இஸ் இட் யூ நீட் டு பேர் இன் மைண்ட். பிளீஸ் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் தி எக்ஸ்பிரஷன் யூஸ்ட் இன் தி மோட்டார் வெஹிக்கிள்ஸ் ஆக்ட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் எனி பர்சன் வார்த்தை தான் உபயோகப்படுத்திருக்கு. எனி பர்சன், எனி பர்சன் டஸ் நாட் மீன் எனி பர்சன். அதான் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஆப்ஜெக்ஷன். லா நாளே வி வில் ஆல்வேஸ் பி கான்ட்ராரியன். லா நெவர் மீன்ஸ் வாட் இட் எவர் இஸ் சாட் டு மீன். தேர்ட் பார்ட்டி, தேர்ட் பார்ட்டின்ற எக்ஸ்பிரஷனுக்கு அடுத்தது இமீடியட்டா தேர்ட் பார்ட்டினா உங்களுக்கு எல்லாம் என்ன தோணும்னா அஸ் அ காமன் பர்சன், ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பர்சன், செகண்ட் பர்சன், தேர்ட் பார்ட்டி. ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பர்சன் இஸ் தி ஓனர் ஆஃப் தி வெஹிக்கிள் அண்ட் தி செகண்ட் பர்சன் வில் பி தி இன்சூரன்ஸ் கம்பெனி. And the third party will be anybody other than these two persons. Motor vahana sattathala adu illa third party. Third party does not mean every person other than the owner and the insurance company. Third party in the context of the Motor Vehicles Act only means a person who is outside the vehicle. A person inside the vehicle is not a third party. Please understand, in the distinction yen draw pannonradhukku ஒரு முக்கியமான இம்பார்ட்டன்ஸ் கொடுக்கிறேன். மிஸ்டர் சத்யஜித் வாஸ் டாக்கிங் அபவுட் கவரேஜ் ஃபார் பர்சன் ஹூ இஸ் டிரைவிங் ஆர் பில்லியன் ரைடர் அண்ட் ஆல். அதெல்லாம் ஆட்டோமேட்டிக் கிடையாது அண்டர் செக்ஷன் 146 மோட்டார் வெஹிக்கிள்ஸ் ஆக்ட்ல. மோட்டார் வாகன சட்டத்துல தெர் இஸ் செக்ஷன் 147 ஒரு ப்ரொவிஷன் இருக்கு. அதுல யாரெல்லாம் ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கா ஸ்டாச்சுட்ரிலி கவர்ட், யாரெல்லாம் கவர்டு கிடையாது அப்படின்னு ஸ்பெசிபிக்கா குறிப்பிடப்பட்டிருக்கு. அப்படி நீங்க பாக்கறச்ச எல்லா தேர்ட் பார்ட்டிஸும் கவர்ட் அப்படின்னு பிரைமா பேசி நம்மளோட எண்ணம் இருக்கும். தட் இஸ் நாட் சோ. பிளீஸ் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட், எ பர்சன் ஸ்டாண்டிங் ஆன் த ரோட் இஸ் அ தேர்ட் பார்ட்டி. இஃப் ஹி இஸ் நாட் அ ஸ்கூட்டர் ஆர் அ கார், ஹி இஸ் ஆப்வியஸ்லி கவர்ட் இஃப் த வெஹிக்கிள் இஸ் இன்சூர்ட். நோ டிஃபிகல்டி அபவுட் தட். பட் அதே ஸ்கூட்டர்ல பில்லியன் ரைடரா ஒருத்தர் போறாருன்னு வச்சுப்போம், ஆர் கார்ல கிராஜுவேட்ஸ் ஆக்குபென்ட்ஸா போறாருன்னு வச்சுப்போம். If he or marathala poi idikkirathu, the rider goes and hits a tree or the driver of the car hits a tree, the occupant gets injured or the pillion rider gets injured, the claim is not there for the pillion rider from the insurance company unless the scooter or the car is covered under what is called as a comprehensive policy. Comprehensive policy indrathu ellarku and the expression you may have seen in newspapers or anywhere. There are two types of policies. Act only policy. In react only na satta pagaram edalla cover panna vendiya kattayam irukum adalla cover pandrathu, that is called as act only policy. Comprehensive policy means that which is wider than the act. But comprehensive does not mean comprehensive. Adha again law love, that is another conundrum. Comprehensive does not automatically mean comprehensive that everybody under the sun is covered. No, comprehensive na ore oru chinna vyathasam from the act policy. Enna na act policy covers only the risk to the third party or the victims who are not on the vehicle. Outside the vehicle yaar road la nadandu poraalo avalla coverage ku, that is called as third party risk, and that will be covered under the act policy. Comprehensive policy means apart from third party risk, you cover the risk to the vehicle damage also. If the vehicle is damaged for which you may have need a repair or a replacement, for that also if you want coverage, you take what is called as a own damage cover. Own damage means vehicle ku enna damage aagumo adha repair pandrathukko replace pandrathukko neenga premium katti you take a own damage cover, and the own damage cover plus third party cover will be called as comprehensive policy or package policy. These are the two expressions which are alternatively used in insurance parlance. Please understand, if you take an act policy for a two wheeler or an act policy for a car, pillion rider and occupant carried in the car are not covered under the policy. Please understand that, bear in mind, this is very very important to be noted. only under a comprehensive policy a pillion rider is covered. Only under a comprehensive policy a gratuitous occupant carried in a car is covered, not under an act policy. Any person அப்படின ஆக்ட்ல ஒரு எக்ஸ்பிரஷன் இருக்கு, third partyன்ற எக்ஸ்பிரஷனும் இருக்கு. Therefore marketல there is a presumption and people assume that anybody and everybody associated in a motor accident will be automatically covered by the insurer. No, please understand and bear this in mind. Only in a comprehensive or package policy a gratuitous occupant is covered or a pillion rider is covered. In the distinction of maathanon soli there have been several calls in Supreme Court, and recent type of Motor Vehicles Act 88 is also sought to be amended. Act 32 of 2019, Parliament has also passed both Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. All provisions have not been notified. Chapter 10 is yet to be notified. As a notify ana kuda, the present position is not going to change. This is the law with regard to motor accidents. Please understand that unless you are traveling in a vehicle which is covered comprehensively, you are not, you will not be protected from a road accident or an injury, and be you a pillion rider or a package or a gratuitous occupant. இது ரெண்டு எப்படி வருதுன்னா, நீங்க காம்ப்ரிஹென்சிவ் பாலிசி எடுத்தா ஓன் டேமேஜ்க்கு ஒரு பிரீமியம் கட்டுவாங்க. யூ வில் நாட் பி பேயிங் எனி அடிஷனல் பிரீமியம் ஃபார் கவரிங் திஸ் பிலியன் ரைடர் ஆர் தி ஆக்குபென்ட். ஓன் டேமேஜ்க்கு நீங்க காம்ப்ரிஹென்சிவ் பாலிசியில எடுக்கறச்சே ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கலி தெர் இஸ் அ பில்ட் இன் ஆர் அன் ஆட் ஆன் கவர் ஃபார் அ கிராட்டிச்சஸ் ஆக்குபென்ட் அண்ட் அ பிலியன் ரைடர் வித் இன்சூரன்ஸ் கம்பெனிஸ் ப்ரொவைட். இதுல மோர் ஆஃப் த மோர் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் க்வெஸ்சன் வில் பி whether the owner himself will be covered if he is driving the car. In the question daily varum owner e cover e covered unda illa na ennude pakkathu veettukaran he takes he borrows the vehicle and goes in the vehicle, whether he will be covered, or when the owner goes or manual la slip a kida undrar adi pattirudhu, or my neighbor or a friend who borrows the vehicle he slips on a manhole and falls down and he is injured, whether he will be covered under the policy of insurance. No, they are not covered under the policy of insurance. Please understand, Motor Vehicles Act la the only person who is covered when he is driving the vehicle is a person who should be a paid driver or a workman. Innudiya driver na pay panni I have engaged somebody as a driver, if he is injured in the course of employment then he will be covered not necessarily under the Motor Vehicles Act but under what is called as WC Act or Employees Compensation Act 1923. Which part, which risk is covered under the Motor Vehicles Act under section 147? So please, and please bear this in mind, because I remember long ago there was a case. Just 1 minute, I'll have a sip of water.
Hey Ragi,
or
bottle
thanni
kodha one.
Sorry, Adla, I remember there was a United Nations led, there was an officer scientist from India, M.M. Rao ne or scientist irundar. He was going in his father-in-law's car. He was going from Chennai to Krishnagiri. Porche, he had his own driver. I still remember all those names, though it is about 30 years old. Ambiraj was the driver. இந்த கார் போர்ச்ச என்னாச்சுன்னா, கிருஷ்ணகிரி ஹைவேஸ்ல போர்ச்ச தேர் வாஸ் அ மவுண்ட் ஆஃப் ஸ்மால் பிரிக்ஸ் ஏதோ கலெக்ட் பண்ணி இட் வாஸ் கெப்ட் இன் தி டார்க் அண்ட் தி டிரைவர் வாஸ் நாட் ஏபிள் டு சீ. அது மேலே ஏறி இறங்கச்சே ஹி ஸ்லிப் அண்ட் தி வெஹிக்கிள் கேப்சைஸ்ட் அண்ட் திஸ் ஜென்டில்மேன் டைட் இன் தி ஜி வி ரமணான் பேர். ஹி வாஸ் அ சோலார் பேஸ் சயின்டிஸ்ட் ஃப்ரம் இந்தியா. ஹி வாஸ் அ பிஹெச்டி ஃப்ரம் கேம்பிரிட்ஜ் இஃப் ஐ ரிமெம்பர் ரைட். However, he died in the accident. When we made the claim for the death of this person in the accident against the insurance company, it was United India Insurance, a public sector. Those days there was only a public sector. 2000 government and private sectors have come. Today we have about 26 or 27 motor insurance including general insurance, 26 or 27 including private players. Four of them are PSUs or public sector. Now what happened when we made a claim, the first defense the insurance company said was the victim is an occupant in the car and therefore he is not required to be covered under Motor Vehicles Act. Appa 147 kedaiyadhu, it was under Motor Vehicles Act 1939, Section 95. They are not covered under the Act, first defense. Second defense is that G.V. Ramana was an occupant in the car in which the driver was engaged by himself, and therefore, he being the master of the driver, the vicarious liability would fall on the deceased, and therefore the victim is not entitled for compensation. It was such a difficult task to convince the court more than the insurance company to prove that even though Motor Vehicles Act does not require coverage for an occupant, the insurance company can cover the risks to the occupant under the motor insurance policy, under a comprehensive policy. Adha convinced panni, and then we were able to establish in by evidence that the vehicle did not belong to the deceased Ramana, but it belonged to his father-in-law, M.A.M. Rao, who was then residing in Canada. Avaroda car nu prove panni, he had borrowed his father-in-law's car and he engaged the driver belonging to his father-in-law. And therefore, he was an occupant who was virtually a third party to the accident, third party to the insurer and the insurance company, to the owner and the insurance company, therefore was entitled to compensation. So please understand this, this is such a difficult distinction that people refuse to believe that the owner of the, and the second thing that you need to understand is, this particular claim was referred to me by one of a very senior labor lawyer who is still among us, NGR Prasad, our career labor lawyer. He will be about 84 or 85 with 60 years experience in the bar. The first and foremost question he posed me was this. What is this, Vijay Raghavan? I am not able to understand. When I take a policy for a motor vehicle which belongs to me, the whole world outside the motor vehicle is covered and they get the benefit of compensation. But if I am the owner of the vehicle and I am driving the car, I am not entitled for coverage. Yes, that is so. Because the Satyadeep point out, Panamari, there is a distinction between life insurance cover and third party insurance cover. The driver, if he dies in the accident or is injured, it will be a life cover virtually for the injured driver. So, avarku, for his own negligence or when he himself is responsible for the accident, he will not be entitled for compensation. But thankfully, insurance companies under a motor insurance policy, they have what is called as Section 3, Roman 3 of the motor insurance policy, where they cover the risk to driver cum owner cum driver. Abdin or specific coverage kudukara. For that, two-wheeler to 1 lakh, four-wheeler to it is about 2 lakhs. Now, what happened is, in Madras High Court, there was a case, Rekha versus United India. And the case led, the issue arose because the deceased person was there, an engineer, and he was entitled to far more compensation than 2 lakhs which was provided under the motor vehicle policy alone. That alone was provided. The court was wondering, why is it that this liability is limited? Why cannot the insurance companies receive more premium and cover a risk to the owner for a higher sum? So what happened is they increased the coverage. They suggested to Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority and increased it to 15 lakhs, maximum of 15 lakhs. For which the premium will be about 750 rupees. Add on risk, only pay for no. But in the particular proposition got completely skewed by reason of the judgment of the Supreme Court sometime in 2017-18, if you see. The Supreme Court said, in the Pudu vehicle, la, India, la unne unne vichukonga, previously, till about 2016, if my statistics are right, one third of the vehicles in India were not insured. One third of the vehicles. It was Gujarat writ petition. This record was put up before the High Court. Now the statistics reveal it's almost 50% of the vehicles in India are not insured. This because I was having a discussion with the Transport Secretary of Tamil Nadu. He was telling me on the complete and the Krishnagiri belt, modalla enik insurance vandi vaangraano annik insurance edukran. அது ஒரு வருஷத்துக்கு இருக்கும் அது முடிஞ்ச அப்புறம் nobody cares to renew the policy at all. So what happened was Supreme Court decided all these new vehicles which are insured are not getting renewed and these policies are only there for 1 year. Why should we not suggest a long-term policy? So what they did was two-wheelers, 3 years, they said it should be purchased for, it should be insured for 3 years. And second thing is, it should, the car should be insured for 5 years. Now 3 years ke nichayama eduthaagano, 5 years ke car ke eduthaagano. Now what happens to the 750 rupees in the 750 rupees premium for the driver cum owner? They would have to shell out 2,250 for the scooter or the two-wheeler and 3,750 for the car. These people started complaining. That is not possible. Already the car for which we are taking a loan, and it will be very difficult for us to pay the EMI. On top of it, the insurance for 3 years for the policy. And now on top of it, the add-on cover for driver cum owner for 5 years or 3 years is too much. So therefore, IRDA should relax it and not insist on 5 years, and give the option to us to cover for less than 15 lakhs also. Ingana, people start making the mistakes. When you take an insurance for a motor vehicle, please understand, you are not taking coverage for yourself as driver cum owner to protect yourself. You are trying to give it as a benefit to the family, which you may leave behind uninsured if you are uninsured. Please understand, angada insurance is an investment. Abhindra concept has to be understood. You are trying to be frugal. You are trying to be save on the premium, by reason of which you are exposing your family after your death or demise to huge risks. They will be without compensation. So adhinala and the aspect, idhila innoru mukhyamana aspect ipo onnu vandirukke. Therefore, I will highlight that aspect. Now that Mr. Satyajit is there, he may, I hope he is listening. As a broker, he may also be interested in that. You please understand, Supreme Court said two wheelers will have to be insured for 3 years, cars should be insured for 5 years. Now what the insurance companies do is, they give the 3 year cover only for the third party risk portion. Please understand, the own damage or the vehicle damage portion is not insured for 3 years. Yena adu varsha varsha marbadum. If the premium that is payable for that own damage portion will differ from insurer to insurer, it may differ from year to year, because the insurers are left, it is not tariffed to that extent. Therefore, the insurers have the choice and option to fix the premium. So 3 years ago policy, if United India, somebody takes a policy today with United India for 3 years. Now what will happen is, the third party portion will be there for 3 years, but the own damage or vehicle damage portion will not be there for 3 years. It will be only for 1 year. So next year he has to renew. If he doesn't renew, or if he renews with some other, for instance, United India la 3 years ago third party insurance cover I have taken this year. Next year I go and take the own damage portion with, say, some other insurance company, Cholamandalam kitta poi I take the renewal for the own damage cover, because the premium is far lesser, or the package that they are offering is much better, so they take. Now, if I know how na, or two wheeler la accident in which you go, two wheeler is involved in the accident. The United India la, you eduthirukkira third party cover will be for second year la. It will not be a comprehensive cover, but it will be only an act only policy cover. Whereas the insurance company, if there is an accident, will say, "Enga kitta ni act only policy da eduthirukka." Adhinala om pillion rider first year undida covered, second year la not covered. The Chola Mandalathla poi, you will make a claim with Chola. United India is saying they are not covering the pillion rider. I have taken the own damage portion with you. You should be covering that. Chola Mandalam will now say, no, we cannot cover you because you have not taken third party cover at all with us. You have taken only own damage cover. Third party portion, United India da ettirkinga. Enga kitta vehicle damage da covered. Pillion rider is not covered under this policy also. Even though you have carefully taken a package policy, you have taken a package policy which has been split between two insurance companies, with the result that the pillion rider or the occupant in the car will not be covered, and there will be serious objections raised. Idu ipo da the Supreme Court court order vandirukku. The accidents are started to arise and the claims may come, and no insurance company will honorably and very sincerely and willingly come forward to settle that claim. What my suggestion to all the what I have written an article on that, what I have suggested is, in these two, in such cases, to resolve the riddle, the claimant should file the claim against both the insurance companies, United India as well as Cholamandalam. They should not say, I have taken this policy with this fellow, that policy with that fellow. they should say, I have taken a comprehensive cover. For reading two together, I am covered as a pillion rider and therefore give the benefit. In all fairness, the courts to resolve this riddle probably say 50% liability jointly and severally to be payable. But this problem is yet to be solved. You can rest assured this problem will become so serious and so manifest because all the new vehicles are having 3 years and 5 years policies and people are getting the second year and third year policies with somebody else. So my advice to you will be, if you have taken a 3 year policy, try and continue your 3 year policy with the same insurer. There is no limit at all. The total compensation that is payable will be payable by the insurance company, except that that should be coverage. Well, all kinds of issues will come if you are a owner of the vehicle. The most important thing you need to understand is you need to see and ensure that the driver who is engaged by you has got a valid driving license. He should have a valid driving license. If he doesn't have a valid driving license, you run the risk of facing the liability to pay the insurer. If the insurance company mele enna panniduvaan court la, they will say that the insurance company pay the award to the third party victim and they will recover the compensation so paid from the owner of the vehicle. So if you are a capable or a financially viable person or an institution which is owning the vehicle, the insurance company can definitely recover the award from the owner of the vehicle. Because in the premium aspect la enna aipochuna, people are trying to make a saving. Now, the most important difficulty in India is, while insurance is compulsory, 100 accident worthar panna kuda, he can go and insist and take a 101st year, he can go and take a policy with the insurance company. No insurance company can refuse. Whereas if you take in England or America, if I have already met with an accident, either next year when I go for insurance cover, even for a third party or
Sir, you are muted, sir.
Sorry.
Yes, sir.
Now you can hear me?
Yes.
Please tell me when I am beyond the time, because very rarely people point out, because I don't know. Normally people don't ask questions. At the end of it, they will ask me, how long do you intend to continue? So I don't want to.
Sir, maybe a couple of minutes more and then we can open it for questions, because people may have very specific questions for both you and Mr. Satyajit.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much for pointing it out. Now, with regard to license, be very, very careful that your driver has got a license and you have also got a license when you are going on the road. Now, recent times, you may have seen judgments where the courts have said if a person drives without a helmet, some portion of the compensation will be reduced. Or license illama pona, something should be reduced, and so on and so forth. All this needs to change. There must be a premium of a road safety ko insurance ko link sonnale inda edathula da and link varudhu. If a person meets with more than one accident, the insurance company should have the right to refuse an insurance cover. And if he rides without the insurance cover, he should run the risk of paying the compensation. Maybe the victim on the road will also be exposed to the risk. But one important aspect, India la compulsory nu sonna kuda, you take the case of South Africa or Australia, avalla enna pannirukanga, and the petrol liye or surcharge mari vaanginde third party insurance ki coverage they are giving. With the result, whether your vehicle is insured or not, it doesn't matter. If you are involved in an accident, there is an inbuilt protection you are getting. Now Mr. Satyajit is also pointing about medical expenses for an accident and all. அது இப்ப வர போற மோட்டார் வெஹிக்கிள்ஸ் அமெண்ட்மெண்ட்ல ஹாஸ்பிட்டலைசேஷன் எக்ஸ்பென்சஸ்க்கு ஒரு கவரேஜ் இஸ் பீங் இன்ட்ரோடியூஸ்ட் பை ரீசன் ஆஃப் ப்ரிபேரிங் பை ஹேவிங் அ காஃபர் எ நியூ காஃபர் இஸ் கோயிங் டு பி கிரியேட்டட் வித் ஆல் தி இன்சூரன்ஸ் கம்பெனிஸ் கான்ட்ரிபியூட்டிங் டு தட் அண்ட் தி கவர்மெண்ட் ஆல்சோ கான்ட்ரிபியூட்டிங் வித் தி ரிசல்ட் இஃப் சம்படி இஸ் இன்ஜூர்ட் இன் அன் ஆக்சிடென்ட் வெதர் ஹி ஹஸ் தி இன்சூரன்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி வெஹிக்கிள் தட் ஹி மெட் வித் அன் ஆக்சிடென்ட் வாஸ் இன்சூர்ட் ஆர் நாட் ஹி ஹஸ் தி பெனிஃபிட் ஆஃப் கவரேஜ் I think that will do. Any specific questions if you have, either to Mr. Satyajit or myself, we'll be glad to answer.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir, for telling us some very important ideas or very important points that we should remember that we were not aware of until now. For example, the comprehensive insurance and the act only insurance, that's something that we were not aware before. And the importance of not switching to another insurance company and continuing with the same company throughout is also important. And the you also highlighted on the drivers that they should also be having a driving license. When you employ anyone, a driver of the vehicle must also have an insurance driving license. Thank you, sir. Now I open the webinar for questions from participants. கேள்விகள் இருந்தால் நீங்கள் சாட் பாக்ஸ்லையும் டைப் பண்ணி கேட்கலாம், இல்லைனா டைரெக்டாக நம்ம ஸ்பீக்கர்ஸ்டையும் நீங்கள் கேட்கலாம்.
My name is Sriram. This is a question to Mr. Vijayaraghavan, sir.
Okay, yeah, you can go ahead. Yeah,
sir, this is with regard to the liability. You are saying that if the existence of a two policy for a same vehicle, one comprehensive OD portion and a liability policy separately, how could a policy liability policy will cover in the ratio of 50-50 when there is no wordings under the policy stipulating that coverage is there?
This has nothing to do with the policy. This will be an innovation that the court will have to make to conclude. See, there are occasions when a financier takes a policy in the name of the hirer. Thereafter, the hirer, without knowing that the financier has taken a policy, may go and take another policy. In such cases also, the policy will never talk about contribution on liability. The courts will say, since both the policies cover the risk on the same day, in all fairness, in equity, not necessarily in law, in equity, the liability should be shared equally. Here, more so, it is a public risk that is thought to be covered. Even though the insurance company can say that we have given only a third party or liability cover for having run the risk of first, in the first year, you have covered a comprehensive policy and you have chosen not to renew the policy, there is a representation that the owner gets coverage for all 3 years for the pillion rider or occupant. So the court can always bring the two insurance companies together and say liability should be equitably shared at 50%. It is not legal based, not law based, but equity based.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
I wanted to also comment on something that Mr. Vijayaraghavan had mentioned earlier, that about penalizing road users who violate the road rules, so, and linking that to insurance. We were just discussing earlier today that there was this news article saying that if you're there is a potential that this may happen, that if you're a repeat traffic offender, you may end up paying higher premiums. This is being discussed right now. So this is quite interesting, and also it would be interesting to hear your thoughts on this.
No, I just circulated that working paper that IRDA, the Insurance Regulatory Development Authority, had constituted a group to go into it and come up with a working paper in which the suggestion has been made. See, all these years, the problem is this. The transport lobby is huge in India. Every year, whenever the premium is escalated, there used to be challenge all over India from the transport lobby. We had occasions, I remember way back in 2003 or 2004, when at around 1:30 or 1:25 on a particular day when the writ petition was being heard, and it was Justice V.S. Sirpurkar who went on to Supreme Court. I was arguing the case on behalf of insurance companies. He was about to dismiss the writ petition at that time, 1:25 it was. And Mr. Rangachari was the IRDA chairman. at 1:26, a fax was produced in court by which the Prime Minister of India, Vajpayee, had sent a letter to IRDA to suspend the increase in the premium at the instance of the All India Transport Congress. This is a huge problem because the commercial vehicles, they are not able to handle the insurance increase even for third-party liability. Now, if you are going to ask even for drivers who are repeat offenders a higher premium, you can rest assured this problem will arise again and again. Even among the, see, what is happening, like in the case of railway passengers, where the commercial traffic people are subsidizing for the passengers who are otherwise traveling. The same problem is happening even for private two-wheelers and private cars. We are all subsidizing for and on behalf of the commercial vehicles. But the time has come when the working paper has to be implemented. The repeat offenders have to be, the premium has to be escalated. Now what will happen is, only this. Supposing the owner of the vehicle has got a vehicle in his name, and he was the driver of the vehicle and he had met with an accident. When he goes for a new insurance policy, insurance company will say that you have to pay higher premium. I will only transfer the registration in the name of my wife and go and insure it so that she will have a clean record from that year. These are all suggestions which we people as advocates can always give and get over this. But the problem is there must be a penalty payable for repeat offenders. The time has come for that. Hello.
Sir, my name is Sriram again. Another question to Mr. Vijayaraghavan, sir. Sir, this is with regard to PA, compulsory PA section of the policy. IRDA said that it has unbundled the cover. Suppose a person has got four vehicles. In one policy, he has taken a PA. And something happens with regard to when he was driving another vehicle, something happens, mishap happens, and he suffers a loss. Will the PA policy will cover the liability?
It will obviously be triggered for under every policy. Please understand, the accident may be one, the cause of action may be one, but there are four different policies for which four different premiums have been paid by him. It is like somebody having a four life insurance policies. He will be entitled to coverage under all four life insurance policies. Cause of action may be one, accident may be one, death may be one. But he has provided for coverage for all four occasions, by paying four times premium.
One clarity is that he has got only, due to IRDA circular, he has taken only PA cover in respect of only one policy.
One vehicle.
In respect of other three vehicles, he has not taken a PA cover.
No, then in that case, whichever vehicle is involved only will come into play. The other vehicle will not come into play. Simple.
Okay.
So, I have a question for Mr. Satyajit. Sir, if there is a road crash happening and there are some casualties and there are third party victims are there, when will they get the amount, the victims' families or kin, when will they get the compensation after the road crash?
Okay, so typically what happens is post an accident, insurance companies would require a list of documents that needs to be submitted. This include an FIR from the police and it would also require, in case of a death claim, it would also require a death certificate to be produced. So post that, the time frame is maximum time frame that the regulator has provided is around 30 days. But most private insurers settle claims much well within that for accidental claims. Less than 10 days is the typical time frame they have, provided you've given the full set of documents.
Thank you, Satyajit.
I also had a question on something that you had mentioned earlier, Mr. Satyajit, about a lot of these policies, like if you are in a accident or even if you have a health condition and you are going to hospital and you're going to use your insurance there. You said you mentioned it's cashless. Is that apply across the board? All are default by cashless, or this is something that one should look out for while considering insurance policies?
Okay, so cashless coverage is provided by every single insurance company that offers health insurance policies. But the network, the range of hospitals that accept cashless will vary from insurance to insurance company. For example, the widest network in the country is empaneled by somebody like with Star Health. So they have the largest number of hospitals in their network. Whereas a relatively new player in the insurance market will have a relatively low, less number of hospitals that are empaneled in their network. So basically, it is completely dependent upon the insurance company's network, which will be available on the website. So before procuring a policy, if you go through their policy website, you will have the network of hospitals that they have tied up, that they have empaneled with. And this list is also dynamic. So it will change from on a month-on-month basis. Sometimes a major hospital may be disempaneled because they are not complying with insurance regulations, or they are not complying with the rate chart that was agreed. So this will keep dynamically changing, but this is something that everybody needs to once go through on the prospectus, or at least on the insurance company's website, to find out if the respective region they reside in has sufficient hospital coverage.
Okay, thank you. Yeah.
Rendu vishayam mukhyamana solidren, please bear that in mind. Life insurance ko அதர் இன்சூரன்ஸுக்கும் இருக்கிற வித்தியாசத்தை பிளீஸ் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட். லைஃப் இன்சூரன்ஸ்ல தேர் ஆர் ஆல்வேஸ் ஏஜென்ட்ஸ். முக்கவாசி நம்ம என்ன பண்றோம், பிரீமியத்தை ஏஜென்ட் கையில கொடுத்து கொண்டு போய் இன்சூரன்ஸ் கம்பெனில கொடுக்க சொல்றோம். பிளீஸ் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட், LIC ரெகுலேஷன்ஸ் ஹவ் மேட் வெரி கிளியர் தட் தி ஏஜென்ட் வென் ஹி ரிசீவ்ஸ் பிரீமியம் ஃப்ரம் தி இன்சூர்ட் அண்ட் பாசஸ் இட் ஆன் டு தி இன்சூரர், ஹி இஸ் நாட் அன் ஏஜென்ட் ஆஃப் தி இன்சூரன்ஸ் கம்பெனி. Please understand that. Now, premium to one, Vyayakarma Niki, I give it to my agent. He goes and delivers next week only. In the meanwhile, there is a claim now. Insurance company can deny the claim if the premium was not there in their kitty within that period plus 30 days grace period. Please understand this distinction. Whereas in the case of motor insurance or fire insurance or health insurance, which is, comes under separate general insurance or health insurance category, premium paid to the agent will be premium paid to the insurance company. இப்ப LIC க்கு LIC regulation statute இருக்கு. அதே மாதிரி private LIC policy எல்லாம் பாத்தீங்கன்னா, there will be a very specific clause in the policy which will always say any premium paid to our agent will not be treated as payment made to us, but it will be treated as payment paid on behalf of the agent, of the insured to his agent. And the agent will be your agent when he receives premium. So please do not assume by paying the money to your agent, you have already paid the premium to your insurance company. Please understand this. இன்னொரு முக்கியமான பிரச்சனை ஒன்று வருது. என்ன பண்றாங்கன்னா, some of the agents, they take cash from you. 10,000 ரூபாய் உங்ககிட்ட கேஷ் வாங்கிப்போம். வாங்கிட்டு ஹி மே யூஸ் இட் இன் த மீன்வைல் அண்ட் 2-3 டேஸ் லேட்டர் ஹி வில் கோ அண்ட் கிவ் அ செக் இன் ஹிஸ் நேம் டு தி இன்சூரன்ஸ் கம்பெனி. யூஸ்வலி இன்சூரன்ஸ் கம்பெனிஸ் தேர்ட் பார்ட்டி செக் வாங்க கூடாது, வாங்க மாட்டாங்க, பட் தேர் இஸ் நோ லா ப்ரோஹிபிட்டிங் தட். சோ சம் ஆஃப் த இன்சூரன்ஸ் கம்பெனிஸ் அகாமடேட் பை ரிசீவிங் அ செக் இஷ்யூட் பை தி இன்சூர்ட் ஏஜென்ட்ஸ் ஆல்சோ. அந்த அந்த செக் பவுன்ஸ் ஆயிடுதுன்னு வெச்சுக்கோங்க, வாட் ஹேப்பன்ஸ் டு தி க்ளைம் ஆஃப் தி ஓனர் ஆஃப் தி வெஹிக்கிள் ஆர் தி ஹெல்த் இன்சூரன்ஸ் ஆர் தி லைஃப் இன்சூரன்ஸ். சோ ப்ளீஸ் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட், தி ஏஜென்ட் இன் தி கேஸ் ஆஃப் அ லைஃப் இன்சூரன்ஸ் இஸ் நாட் an ஏஜென்ட் ஆஃப் தி இன்சூரன்ஸ் கம்பெனி when he takes premium from the insured. He acts as your agent. Whereas under other insurance policies, he acts as the agent of the insurance company, so you are protected. உங்ககிட்ட கேஷ் வாங்கிட்டு அவன் போய் தன்னோட செக் கொடுத்து அந்த செக் பவுன்ஸ் ஆனா கூட, யூ கேன் ஸ்டில் ப்ரூவ் யுவர் கிளைம் அண்ட் கெட் இட் ஃப்ரம் தி இன்சூரன்ஸ் கம்பெனி, பிகாஸ் தி மணி பெய்ட் டு தி ஏஜென்ட் ஆஃப் அ ஜெனரல் இன்சூரன்ஸ் கம்பெனி இஸ் மணி பெய்ட் டு தி இன்சூரன்ஸ் கம்பெனி இட்செல்ஃப். இந்த டிஸ்டிங்ஷன்ல சி, தீஸ் ஆர் ஆல் வெரி டிஃபிகல்ட் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் அன்லெஸ் யூ ஹவ் பிராக்டிஸ்ட் அண்ட் எக்ஸ்போஸ் டு லாட் ஆஃப் இஷ்யூஸ். ஐ கேன் கிவ் யூ 101 எக்ஸாம்பிள். ஒரு சின்னதா ஒரு ஸ்டோரி சொல்லி நான் ஐ வில் ஜஸ்ட் கம்ப்ளீட் தட். This was with regard to one of my friends who is now a judge of the Madras High Court. Avanoda sister vandi, she had a desktop publishing. Now she was having a desktop publishing somewhere in Nanganallur. Adla enna chinna, when she was having a desktop publishing, suddenly the computer which was working one fine day, it just conked out. The electronic items, please understand, they may go conk out in any time for no reason at all. But insurance company, even under a fire policy or whatever, unless it is precipitated by an accident or triggered by an extraneous influence, which is from outside, the claim will not be covered. On its own computer, so avan kalangathala enak phone panni sonna enoda sister desktop publishing la irukada didirna enoda phone ava computer vela seiyala, she has to comply with the order. Periya university edho Princeton university ku order kadachirukku. If she doesn't do it, she is in trouble. Insurance company ki claim poda pora, what is the protection I need to have? So I told him, you take down a letter, I will dictate to you. You give that letter, the claim will be settled. Na solra maari nee kudukalena, you are in deep trouble nu sonna. So I dictated the letter. Dear sir, regarding insurance policy, on such and such day, at such and such place, when our desktop unit was publishing, a couple of monkeys suddenly entered the premises and they were on the roof of the premises. When we tried to shoo away the monkeys, one of the frightened monkeys fell on top of the computer, and ever since the computer has stopped working. And therefore the claim, please settle the repair claim for the computer or the replacement. The surveyor appoint pannavar Anandakrishnan nu nanna nyabaru 60 years experience. Avar aniki ulla varche and the premises ulla varche and the Nanganallur area la, I believe it was infested with lot of monkeys of those days. So avar ulla varche rendu korangu vandu and the premises la irundha. So he took photographs of that ella unman solli prohibited. இதே இப் தட் கேர்ள் ஹட் ரிட்டர்ன் த லெட்டர் ஆன் த கிரவுண்ட், என் கம்ப்யூட்டர் நான் வேலை பண்ணிட்டே இருந்தேன், திடீர்னு வேலை எல்லாம் நின்று போச்சு. சோ ஐ அம் மேக்கிங் அ கிளைம், நான் த கிளைம் வுட் ஹவ் பீன் ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கலி டினைட் ஆஸ் நாட் பீங் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் ஆக்சிடென்ட். நான் போய் சொல்லி கிளைம் வாங்குங்கல்ல சொல்லி தரல. பட் பி கேர்ஃபுல் பை எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஐ எம் கிவிங் இஸ் டு டெல் யூ, பிஃபோர் யூ ரைட் யுவர் லெட்டர் டு தி இன்சூரன்ஸ் கம்பெனி அபவுட் ஹவ் யுவர் கிளைம் ஹஸ் அரிசன், பிளீஸ் கன்சல்ட் சம்படி ஹூ நோஸ் த சப்ஜெக்ட் and then make your claim. Otherwise, you are in deep trouble, because once you have said whether it's truthful, poyyo, nejamo, eduva irundhalo, ungalku policy la irukkira clause theriyama neenga andha vaarthaigala upayoga paduthineenga na, your claim is in deep trouble. Please understand that. Number one, policy edukkarchevum, be careful. Claim podachevum, be careful. If you have taken a policy properly, if underwriting is very good, then your claim will automatically follow, no difficulty at all. So please take advice either before you take insurance or before you lodge a claim with the insurance. This is not to canvas business for myself, but I am saying generally try to consult people who know the subject and do it. Otherwise you will get into trouble for no fault of yours.
Thank you, sir. We still have a few minutes. If anybody has any questions or comments to share, please, you can unmute yourself and ask those questions to any of our speakers.
Sir, one question to Vijay Raghavan, sir. Number newspapers, constantly get news items that government vehicles, especially buses, when they are involved in road crashes, the victims are not paid the compensation amount, and the courts take over one or two buses from the depot and they put it park it in the court. And what happens, sir? Would the victims get compensation when government vehicles are involved in crashes?
This is a huge subject by itself. I will just tell you very, very briefly. Section 146 Motor Vehicles Act, anybody who understands plain English, you can read it. Adila, there is an exemption provided if it's a government vehicle. They
is not compulsory. It is open to the government not to insure. For instance, High Court liye avanga vandi illa not insured. Recently, I have been referred a claim where a judge's own vehicle, a car was involved. You know, a car, it has hit somebody and the vehicle is not insured. And FIR naturally court la vandu nice and innor vandi mela porta court mela pora court vandi mela podave illa. These are all difficulties. When you come to government vehicle, avanga insurance edukkrade illa. There are many reasons for which they don't take insurance. Insurance company la poi policy eduka pona insurance companies also will refuse, because so far as government vehicles are concerned, it is not compulsory. Compulsory na poi insurance keta insurance company cannot refuse to give me a cover. Because it's compulsory, they have to give the cover. But if a government vehicle goes, government goes and takes, asks for cover, the insurance company will refuse, because it's a very, very costly portfolio. It's a loss-making portfolio. There are several instances of Punjab, Haryana, or Gujarat, or Karnataka, or Kerala. They have taken insurance for these vehicles. For instance, Karnataka, la enna pannirukanga, they have formed societies with the lots of vehicle owners. Societies have been formed and they have insured the society. With the result, those vehicles are hired by the society to the government, and the government runs the vehicle. If an accident occurs, the vehicles will be covered, because they are not government owned, but owned by the society. But Tamil Nadu, if you see, vehicles are not owned by the are owned by the government. They are not insured at all. But in the insurance, eduka solli compulsory pannona, I myself have written several articles in newspapers also. I have published papers. I have gone and spoken in so many conferences. Nobody is bothered, because it's a money-making portfolio. And the insurance and the accident claims, there is a huge sum of money available also for the repairs and replacement of parts. அதெல்லாம் இன்சூரன்ஸ் கம்பெனிக்கு போயிடுதுன்னா தேர் வில் பி எ ஹியூஜ் லாஸ். அண்ட் ஃப்ரம் த வக்கீல் பாயிண்ட் ஆஃப் வியூ சொல்றேன், பப்ளிக் கவர்மெண்ட் வண்டியெல்லாம் இன்வால்வ்னா கவர்மெண்ட் அட்வொகேட்ஸ் வில் பி ஆன் த பேனல். எல்லா கவர்மெண்ட் அட்வொகேட்ஸ் வில் லூஸ் தர் பேனல் பொசிஷன் இஃப் தி இன்சூரன்ஸ் இஃப் தி வெஹிக்கல்ஸ் ஆர் ஆல் இன்சூர்ட். ஸோ தேர்ஃபோர் இட்ஸ் யூ ஸ்கிராச் மை பேக், ஐ ஸ்கிராச் மை பேக், நோபடி இஸ் பாதர்ட் அன்லெஸ் தெர் இஸ் அ மூவ்மெண்ட் அண்ட் ஆர் சம்படி ஃபைல் த பப்ளிக் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் லிட்டிகேஷன் அண்ட் சேஸ். நீங்க சொன்ன மாதிரி இப்ப கவர்மெண்ட் வெஹிக்கல்ஸ் எல்லாம் வேற இன்சூரன்ஸ் கிளைம்ஸ் ஆர் கெட்டிங் செட்டில்ட் சோ அர்லி அண்ட் டெபாசிட்டட் அவார்ட்ஸ் ஆர் கெட்டிங், வேற கவர்மெண்ட் வெஹிக்கல்ஸ் அட்டாச் பண்ணி கலெக்டர் ஆபீஸ்ல இல்ல போலீஸ்ல போய் வண்டியை அட்டாச் பண்ணி தென் ஒன்லி த விக்டிம்ஸ் ஆர் கெட்டிங். வை ஷுட் த கவர்மெண்ட் நாட் இன்சூர் த வெஹிக்கல்ஸ்? சம்படி கேன் ஃபைல் அ ரிட் பெட்டிஷன். பிகாஸ் வை இட் இஸ் பாசிபிள், நான் சொல்றேன். அந்த செக்ஷன் 146ல வாட் இட் சேஸ் இஸ் தி கவர்மெண்ட் நீட் நாட் இன்சூர் தர் வெஹிக்கல்ஸ் if they have a corpus which they have created out of which they can settle such claims. In the corpus vandu Tamil Nadu la, for instance, 1956 la 5 crore rupees create pannanga, and the 5 crore rupees zero aayi na 60 varsham aapodhu ippo. There is no money available under the corpus at all, so not insuring those vehicles is totally illegal. But somebody has to take it up, and then possibly the courts, if the courts direct and the issue gets exposed, the government may come up with the insurance for the, and the insurance companies who refuse pannada irukanum abadina, and the exemption from that 146 has to be removed. Adha remove pannalena no insurer will be willing to insure. That difficulty will continue. So the act may have to be amended by saying, just as a private vehicle is compulsory to be insured, government vehicles also should be compulsorily insured. That is the only solution.
Thank you, sir. Any more questions? Sumana, I think we have there are no questions right now. Do you think we can conclude?
Yeah, sure. It's been quite an engaging hour and a half or more, and I'd really like to thank both our speakers, Mr. Sadhyajit and Mr. Vijayaraghavan, for trying to make us all lay people a little more knowledgeable on this very vast and complex subject of insurance, especially pertaining to the Motor Vehicles Act and road safety in particular. And I think for all of us, it was a bit of an eye-opener. We learned a little bit, and I'm sure this will only help us figure out more on this topic and be a great starting point to figuring out our personal insurance or understanding why it's important and getting a deeper sense of this subject. So thanks to both of them for spending their time with us today and for sharing a little bit of their vast knowledge with us. And so thank you both for coming here today. And thank you to all the participants for taking time to join us. And we hope it was useful for all of you. And if you do have any questions later, feel free to send it to us and we will try to get more information for you from both our speakers. And we hope this was useful. And thank you everyone for joining us today.